Semen retention is really just about defeating your demons. That's really what it is. And that's what it comes down to. And if we just define demons, you can use that term loosely, however you want to use it. They're just things that distract us. They're entities, you could call them energies, that negatively affect humans, or maybe even other beings too. But NOFAP is a battle. Semen retention is an experiment in war. It's a battle. It's a warrior's invitation between the lower nature, the higher nature. And you may never try semen retention, and that's okay. You may never try to transmute this sexual core energy that is in you as a man. That's okay. No one's judging you. We're all out here doing our best. But that's really what semen retention is. It's not even personal development. It's not self-help. It's not something that just like, oh, I did this thing, whoopee, go me. It's a spiritual endeavor in which you are deciding to learn more about who you are, what you value, what you give importance to. And a lot of people don't like the word hierarchy, but when we have principles and values, by necessity, you are deciding this thing is higher on the hierarchy than this thing. Now, semen retention is one of those things. And I've talked about this before in other videos. It's not just in Christianity or being a monk or being some guru on the Ganges River and just being celibate forever. I don't think I'll be celibate forever. In fact, I can kind of feel, I can guarantee that I won't be. But this is about carving out your kingdom as a man. That's what this is about. And not letting internal forces and external forces on a mental, emotional, and I'll say it, spiritual level, take you down using the physical. This is what it's about. When I was 9, my mom was converting to Greek Orthodox Christianity. And this is relevant, I swear. Just stay with me. When I was 9, I was growing up in Georgia, and my mom was going through it, some major depression, and she found Orthodox Christianity. And one of the things that she found was the ascetic tradition, the monks, the nuns, who leave the world. And it really opened up in my 9-year-old mind some kind of seed that I think is expressing itself now. And I just turned 33. Happy birthday to me 2 days ago, September 13th. Shout out to all my other Virgo if you do astrology at all. When I was 9, I was baptized in Greece in a women's monastery. And which patron saint did I choose? Saint George. Saint George, the trophy bearer, he's called. I took on a new identity. I literally took on a new identity with a new name. The old man died, and I was born anew, you could say, in Christ. If you really want to stretch it, you could say in Christ consciousness, in some mystical new way. Saint George is the guy who's known for slaying the dragon and saving the woman. Saving the beautiful maiden. And if that's not the definition of a Chad, then I don't know what is. See, religion doesn't have to be boring and prudish. Religion and spirituality can be real turn-ons, and they can be practically applied to your life today in the situation you find yourself in. This is what I stand for. This is part of my message to you, to y'all on my channel. I have this kind of in my spiritual bloodline, you could say, my blood, my genetics, my makeup, this fire in my belly, is to go to the unknown, to have challenge. And it's my contention that you do too. And you're probably being faced, as we all are. You may, if you're anywhere from 16 to 50, especially as a man, you're being invited to go on your hero's journey. Only you can hear the call. And I'm going to talk more about my own journey so far and how I listened to the call, how I rejected the hero's call. I pushed it off. I justified why I don't need to. And then finally, about 6 years ago, 5 years ago, I took the leap. And I started to individuate myself. I lost a lot. I made mistakes. But one thing I have to give myself is I answered the call. Now I'm talking like this tonight because I'm very inspired to support and encourage you who may be at the start of that journey. You may be feeling average. You may be feeling, man, where is my potential? Why am I not feeling like the man that I know I can be? It's because maybe, and I say this with love and compassion, but I also add in some masculine spice to it. Maybe there's a call you're not answering. Maybe you're being called to adventure, to the unknown, to the chaotic, to things you may not be able to control. Maybe parts of you may need to die. Maybe some addictions need to die. Maybe some old gross habits need to be put to death. Maybe you need to go kill your dragon. Good place to start is taming your physical dragon. I'm no scientist, but if you can master your sexual energy in a disciplined yet graceful way and refine that energy and make yourself a magnet for God's divine energies, who would regret trying that? That's my invitation to you. If you are hearing a hero's call, take it. Take the leap. Start today. Make a commitment, make a decision to yourself. Hell, say it to God right now. If you're watching this video, God, I'm ready. I'm ready. I'm ready to man up. And what's going to happen is you're going to go on your journey. And there's going to be things from your unconscious that are going to come up. Somebody commented in the last video, they said, hey, I'm feeling a ton of lust. Normal. Hey, I'm feeling a ton of sadness. Normal. This is the unknown. You are the unknown. You are learning to slay your inner demons. And it's a hell of a ride. I just got chills. Go for it, bro. Go for it. No more waiting. Go for it.